We're going to call this the Nick Saban rule. And Nick Saban was notorious for showing up to job interviews incredibly prepared for what they needed, okay? And what I mean by that is he always showed up to a job interview and he had done extensive homework on how he was going to solve the unique problems of the university that was looking at hiring him, okay? So the Nick Saban rule is this. You need a notepad. It looks like this. You need to sit down and spend time thinking about your clients. How do I help them achieve this? How do I help them do this? How do I help them do this? So this morning in our sales meeting, I was going through the psychology of a buyer, okay? And I was talking about this. These are reasons that people would hire us as their coach. You need to be thinking about this. You need to be teaching your team. What's the psychology of the people that are hiring you? Let me put it another way. What do they want? Okay, so I look up here. In my world, they're stuck or they're static, some complexity or confusion. They're underperforming, either their person or their team. They have missing structures. They have some pain or they're moving towards some pleasure. They are like-minded people. We share the same beliefs. They believe that with a good coach, we can perform at a much higher level. They're looking for an advantage in a world of saturation or commoditization. They want to dominate, which is where my big players are, my 40K members, or my Millionaire Club members, my 25K members. They want to dominate. They want to dominate. If a person pays $25,000, we can get them a $250,000 increase. That's getting them to a much better state, okay? And it's nothing. They've got a desire. They're looking for clarity. They've got a desire to do something in their life. So what you should be thinking as you're breaking down your clients is, why are our clients hiring us? And if we're digging in and have built a process to get them to a much higher level, then they should be telling other people about us.